Too Bright to Hear, Too Loud to See by Juliann Garey. Narrated by Dan Butler. We are able to find everything in our memory, which is like a dispensary or chemical laboratory in which chance steers our hand sometimes to a soothing drug and sometimes to a dangerous poison. Marcel Proust, In Search of Lost Time. I wondered if a memory is something you have or something you've lost. Woody Allen, Another Woman. First, willing suspension of disbelief. That's what they call it in the movies. Like the story about how each procedure will be over in less than a minute, and how you won't feel a thing. How you may be foggy for a while, but in the end, you'll be better. You'll be whole. I want that. So I suspend my disbelief. I let them hook me up, willingly. And then they give me something. And when I close my eyes, I am neither asleep nor awake, but rather suspended in the dark, somewhere between the two. Willingly suspended. Watching. I feel my eyelids being taped shut and hear the gentle hum of the electricity. I have no choice but to give in and let the story tell itself. Los Angeles, 1984. California is a no-fault state. Nothing is ever anyone's fault. It just is, day after day, until it kills you. Automatic sprinkler clicks on at dusk, flattens oak leaves, yellowy brown veined, against stiff green lawn. It is a warm September night when I leave my wife and 8-year-old daughter. I tell my wife I'm going out to the backyard to clean up the dog shit. It's the one chore I've never really minded. A couple of times a week, I use a long-handled yellow plastic pooper scooper that came with an accessory, a narrow rake designed to help roll the turds into the scooper. I make my way systematically across the lawn in a zigzag pattern. The dogs, a couple of beautiful overbred Irish setters who suffer from occasional bouts of mange, enthusiastically follow, sniffing as if hot on the trail of something other than their own crap. When the scooper gets full, I dump it into one of the black Rubbermaid garbage cans I keep in the garage. And when I'm done, I spray down my equipment with a fierce stream from the gun-like attachment I screw on to the green hose I use to top off the swimming pool. By the time I'm finished, the scooper is clean enough to eat off of. Jesus Christ, Grayson! My wife, Ellen, yells out the kitchen window. It would be a whole lot easier if you do that during the day when you could actually see the shit. This is something she yells out the kitchen window almost ritually. But I always do it at night. I like the challenge. Ellen accuses me of being antisocial. It's not true. My work as a studio executive demands a tremendous amount of social intercourse, the appearance of impeccable interpersonal skills, the ability to read the room better and faster than anyone, to negotiate every situation graciously and ruthlessly to my advantage. I can hardly breathe. I use the front door less and less these days. Want the ritual welcoming of the hunter breadwinner less and less. Instead, most nights I let myself in through the little gate that leads to the backyard. I desperately need a solitary hour to catch myself by the scruff of the neck and stuff myself back inside that hollow, glad-handing shell. He is all style and glitter and fast-talking charm. I cannot stand to be inside him when he does it. Now the best I can do is stand next to him and watch. I used to love my job. Didn't even mind the commute. After a cool rain or a good stiff breeze, the sickly yellow mattress of smog that hangs cozily over the valley dissolves briefly. You can inhale without...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.